What's up, Nightwalkers? Today, I'm going over the SureShot Night Vision SNB filter. SNB stands for Signal to Noise Booster. How this thing's marketed is it's marketed as a filter that increases the perceived signal to noise ratio of your device. The way that you use the filter is you gotta remove the eye cup ring. Now, if your device is new, you got it brand new assembled from somebody, this thing's gonna be in here pretty damn tight. So you gotta use a gripper pad. Sometimes you might need to use a tool. If you use a tool, just be careful you're not going to scratch your lens, you know, if you're trying to get a screwdriver or something like that inside these slots. But anyways, you can expect this thing to be really hard to turn. You turn it counterclockwise, and once you break it loose, you know, it unscrews pretty easy. You're going to have a bunch of crap from the threads, you know, that'll probably get all over the lens. So just take some compressed air, you know, like a keyboard duster, and just blow it out of there. Make sure it's nice and clean. Then you take your SNB filter, you know, it's plastic. So compared to the eye cup ring, which is metal, you know, you just gotta be careful that you're not gonna cross thread it and screw up the threads. You know, obviously you go counterclockwise till you hear it pop and then get it in there. And once it's in place, you know, it's pretty similar to the eye cup ring in terms of how it goes in there. And so this is something that's nice. So for example, if you're running one of those cameras that clamp on here to the eye cup, ring, you know, right in this spot right here, then it's going to be compatible. Whereas some of the other amber filters that I've used, you know, they just mount flush, they screw in flush into the threads, and so you don't have the actual ring sticking up, you know, to clamp onto. So that's kind of slick. And just to kind of show you before the videos here of what it looks like. So this is an L3 unfilmed white phosphor tube. I got the day cover on, so I turn it on. Here's your typical color that you can expect from an L3 unfilmed tube in white phosphor. And just to kind of give you an example, so you can kind of see the color difference. And once you get it in there, you'll notice how much darker it makes the color. And this is at max gain. So that's max gain. And you can tell it's definitely a bit darker. It has a definite purple or dark blue color to it. And so here up next, I'll show you in the videos how this thing looks in low light conditions and then with the moon. Okay, right here is max gain, and this is on a no moon night, the same exact night. Cloud cover, as you can see, and you can notice how much darker the SNB is. Same night, max gain still, and for both shots, and as you can tell how much darker the SNB is, but it does definitely clean up some of the snow effect that you see. Okay, this is a quarter moon night. The moon is on its way down, and even with these brighter conditions, you can see how much darker the SNB is. Same night at the quarter moon, max gain for both video shots. As you can see from the videos, the SNB filter noticeably darkens up the image to your eye of what the scene looks like with your night vision. Now, does it actually increase the perceived signal to noise ratio to your eyes? Myself personally, I don't feel like it does that, but where I do see the SNB filter having some value for sure with a white phosphor device is if you have an image tube inside the device, you know, whether it's a PVS-14 or you're running an auto gain goggle like RNVGs, something like that, without the ability to lower the gain or have, you know, manual gain control, then that's where the SNB filter can definitely have a role. So for example, if your tube is producing excessive scintillation, you know, the snow that you see, it'll definitely reduce that while at the same time of making the tube appear darker to your eyes, but it does reduce the scintillation, as you can see from the videos. The other thing that's nice with the filter with a auto gain type tube is on a bright night, you know, the full moon, close to a full moon, something like that. If your eyes are sensitive to that level of brightness, then putting the filter in here definitely darkens the image and reduces the brightness. And so that's one way that you can definitely lower the brightness, you know, to your eyes if you don't have any way to control the gain through the device. And so for those two things, I definitely, you know, see a benefit for the SNB with white phosphor tubes for people like that. Now, some people, they like filters, other people don't. You know, me personally, I don't really like filters that much just because it gives you a darker image. And me personally, I prefer a brighter image. But that doesn't mean that you might not like it. Everybody's different. You know, some people like filters just the way they look. You know, possibly the color. You may like the color compared to the standard color that comes on these tubes. And so for the cost of it, you know, they're $80 each for the filters. So $160 for the pair. When you buy them, you got to buy them separately, you know, one at a time. So I think if it's something you're interested in, it's definitely worth to buy one of them, see how you like it. And if you like it, then obviously you pick up a second one if you got dual tubes. So anyways, I just want to put this video together for you, kind of show you what the video looks like of running the filter, in low light conditions and then in brighter conditions with more moon out there. So hopefully that might help you make a decision in terms of if this is something that you want to look at picking up. So anyways, I hope you enjoyed the video and thanks for watching.